Hello everybody, my name is Stefan and today I want to show you something that we've been working on here at Checkly for the past few months. If you don't know Checkly, Checkly is a monitoring service that you can use to do uptime monitoring and get alerted when your APIs go down. You can use it to do detailed API checks and tests for proper HTTP status codes and response bodies, and you can even use it to do end-to-end tests using Puppeteer and Playwright to make sure that your applications are doing what they're supposed to. Now, a lot of people reached out to us and asked, hey, how could we use Checkly to monitor our APIs that aren't servers behind firewalls? Or how could we use Checkly to check and monitor applications running in virtual private clouds? So far, that hasn't been possible, but we went to the drawing board and I want to now show you how you can do just that. So let me go to my terminal, and what I will do is I will make an HTTP call to an internal API that I have running here in my own little private network. And what this API is doing is that it is controlling the light just behind me. So you see there that the light is now turned on, and when I call the API endpoint again, it is turned off again. So now it would be wild if people from the internet could kind of mess with my private lighting situation here, but I still want to make sure that the API is up and running using Checkly. So how could I do this? Let's go to the Checkly UI, and you see here, this is the check overview dashboard, and you see that I have already a few API and browser checks defined. But there is now a new area available that is called private location. So private locations allow you to run checks on applications within your own segregated network, like this one here in my apartment. So let's create a new private location. What you have to do is you have to give it a name. So let's call it simply my network. You can give it an icon, and I know that there is a little light bulb in there, which I think is nice. And now Checkly is telling us about an API key. And you might now wonder, wait a second, how is this going to work? Let me show you. So the way it works is that we now provide a new tool that is called the Checkly agent. The Checkly agent is a container that runs in any OCI compliant container runtime. This includes Docker, Kubernetes, and other tools. And you can now kick off and start this container in your infrastructure. This container then needs two things. It needs access to the internet, and to be specific, it needs access to agent.checklyhq.com, and it needs then access to your internal APIs and applications. So should we set it up? I think we should. What we can do now is, you see here a little Docker command that I will copy, and I will place that in my terminal. And you see here that there is a placeholder for the API key that I just copied. So let's run this command, and this is now all it takes to start this Docker container. To make sure it's running, let's do a quick Docker PS to see it's there. And indeed, you see there that now the Checkly agent is running on my machine, in my environment, in my network. And that's pretty much all the setup that we need to do. I can now go to the check overview, and I can create a new API check. Let's give it a name. Let's call it light switch. We have to define the HTTP method and the URL. And here's now a specific thing, because I'm running Docker on a Mac in my own private network. So to reach out from the container to the surrounding host network, I have to use host Docker internal. For your use cases, that might not apply. But what I can do now already, I can choose a location to run a test from here, select the location, and let's see if this is already working. So I'm making this request, and what you see now is, indeed, Checkly was now able to make this request to my internal API. So you see here that we see the response body that we also saw in the terminal, and this is pretty nice and good to go. There are a few other things that we can configure. So you could configure setup and teardown scripts if you want to do setup and cleanup steps for your API checks. And you might have noticed that the little modal showed us that this API call has degraded performance. Let's change threshold values so that Checkly is not alerting me because my API is slow, because there's little things to do about that here right now. Let's do a nice assertion here, or a quick assertion here, to check that the API hopefully is returning with a 200 and not with a error status code like a 500 or something. And then we can pick our network, and we can deselect Frankfurt and Stockholm, because Frankfurt and Stockholm cannot access my little lighting network here anyways. With this, we can define an interval to define how often the checks are running. And now we are already good to go. Let's run this again. And hopefully the little degradation warning is now gone and see if it's still working. Sweet. This check is awesome. I think everything is up and running and I think we are good to go. So using the Checkly agent, you can set up the agent in your infrastructure to access your internal APIs and can still use the scheduling, monitoring, and alerting that we provide you with the Checkly infrastructure. And you can then use the agent to monitor your internal IoT setup like I do, or any business critical APIs and applications that you are running in your infrastructure. And in fact, we have already customers that are using the Checkly agent to monitor banking APIs to make sure these are up and running. And they're using Kubernetes to scale up and down the agent because that's what it's built for. So if you want to learn more, you can head over to the docs. There's a new section available that is called Private Locations. It includes a bunch of more information on how to scale and set up the agent and how to work with private locations. And I hope you are as excited as I am about this new feature, and I see you around.